stay glossy. I lived at Boyer and Mount Pleasant, right on the corner. And on my way to school, I would pass by Studio International. And it was a stained glass studio. And every couple weeks I'd walk by, there would be a sample panel hanging like these over here. Matter of fact, a couple of these were some of the first ones Mr. Crocker made. After he made about six or eight of them, I was curious and I stopped to see how he was making these things. And that's where I was until I graduated high school. I spent more time with Mr. Crocker than I did at home. When I graduated high school, I had a four-year art scholarship from the Philadelphia College of Art. But then I thought about it, and I was thinking, ain't no way in hell I'm gonna make it for 4 years in college because I was a knucklehead growing up. So when I was 17, I went to the Marine Corps to get out of Philadelphia. I went to see the recruiter like August 22nd, 1979. August 28th, I was standing on the yellow footprints of Paris Island thinking to myself, what the hell did I get myself into? Thinking that I turned down an art scholarship and all this crap to deal with this. But once I went in the Corps, I stayed in the Corps for 21 years, retired first sergeant. Mr. Crocker brought me here and I saw the place. And Richard Forster, the guy who owned the place, wanted to sell. So I ended up, coming here like June 2000, and we finished all the paperwork and closed in December of 2000. And of course, I bought the building, I bought the place. So here I am. So many people do stained glass, have no business doing stained glass, none. These idiots that took this panel apart and restored it probably about 60 years ago, when they took the window apart, you have cement around each piece of glass that makes the window watertight, airtight once you take it out the lead. Well, when they took the window apart, they didn't take the old cement off. So when they put it back together with new lead, it made the window expand. It expanded so much that they cut these borders from this width to this width. They had to cut the window down, and then they had ULED all the way around the window because it expanded because they didn't know what they were doing. So now I have to cut all new borders because when I put it together, it's not going to expand because I remove all the cement from the old crap they left on and what they also put on. The problem is a lot of the people who were doing stained glass when I started have died or retired. And a lot of these people, once they, give up the ghost, there's no one replacing them. You're talking people who have 50, 60 years of knowledge. And you can't just, plug in a UP cord and take that knowledge. It goes with them to the grave. So that's the problem with stained glass, is a lot of people who are really good at it are gone. When I was in the Marine Corps, there's no room for none of the prejudice crap. Because you judge someone by their performance, by their character, the way they conduct themselves. You don't judge someone by looking at them and thinking, oh, because of their skin color, they may be lesser or whatever. But once I bought Cathedral, there's been many a times I went to churches like out in Lancaster and they call up, they want an estimate to have their windows restored. I go out, take all the information, do the estimate, send them the estimate. 2-3 weeks go by, don't get no phone call. So I call them up, don't get no answer, leave a message, never call me back. Because they don't know over the phone if you're green, purple, black, yellow, whatever. But when you show up, a lot of times I could see it in their face. They'll treat you, you know, they'll, you know, say hi and all that and show you what they want done. But after that, never hear from them again. And that's only for one reason. But see, I don't worry about the job I didn't get. I just worry about the jobs that I'm working on and the jobs that I can get.